She's been in the entertainment industry for over 12 years, and Bonang Matheba needs no introduction. Lindy Wesitole sat down with her to chat about brand Bonang and being chosen to MC the Global Gift Nelson Mandela Centenary Dinner in London. A host of stars such as Vanessa Williams, Mariah Carey, and will.i.am were at the dinner.
Bonang,
yes.
Thank you for making the time to speak to us.
Only a pleasure. Only a pleasure. Thank you for having me.
So you will be hosting Mandela's centenary dinner in London.
Absolutely.
How does it feel to be selected for this? And secondly, what will be happening?
Well, it is a bit overwhelming. I've been part of the Global Gift Foundation now for over a year. Mm-hmm. It is a national initiative, an international initiative that was founded by Maria Bravo, who is in Spain. And her idea behind it was to support CSI projects around the world, things that she's passionate about. Last year, she invited me over to London. I met Eva Longoria, I met Victoria Beckham, I met other members of the Global Gift Foundation team. Mm-hmm. And they fell in love with me and how passionate I am about education through the Bonang Matheba Bursary Fund. And she said, well, let's see how we could work together, raise funds, raise awareness, because you've got amazing projects and so do I. Let's come together and see what we can do. And this year the Nelson Mandela Foundation is obviously celebrating its centenary, so they are hosting a gala in London at the Rosewood Hotel in honor of Udada. And they asked me to come along. Seeing as I am a South African, I will be celebrating a South African icon. I think I was a perfect fit. And what happens usually at those dinners is that it is a culmination of really incredible, world leaders, celebrities, people around the world who have influence, with power, who have very strong voices to help us kind of echo the messages that we're trying to, to share with people. Yeah. This year, we're trying to, tell the story of Udada and now the late Mama Mandela, and, just kind of explain to people what their legacy means to a normal South African. Raise funds, tell them about the foundation, tell them about the Nelson Mandela Children's Hospital, auctioning off some really delicious goodies, diamonds and gowns. And these are really, the room will be filled with millionaires. And usually we leave there having raised so much money. And again, that's what we're trying to do this year.
Oh my, before we even get into anything else, I want to know, we all want to know, what will you be wearing?
I haven't thought about it too much. Definitely an African designer. Mm-hmm. When you have an opportunity to be on an international platform like that, I love to make sure that I bring it back home. I celebrate Batabakokhai, I will definitely be wearing a duk as well. Mm-hmm. A couple of weeks ago, the South African celebrity, South African women celebrated Umama with the hashtag all black with a duk. So I said, you know what? I'm going to pay homage to my mama too, the mother of the nation. I'm going to be wearing a duk with a beautiful evening gown. But I think on that day, it's important that, she's remembered, and she's part of the night too.
And then now, when we spoke earlier about Utata's legacy.
Yes.
And living the legacy as Ubonang and also as a South African, mm-hmm. how are you living Dada's legacy?
I think, Dada always said, and the only thing he wanted to do and say to people was that you must just be a better version of yourself. What is it in your small capacity, big or small, how can you change the world? How can you use your voice to make other people's worlds better? How can you leave a small change? How can you make other people's lives better? How can you make somebody else smile? And I think he epitomized that, and he wanted other people to be that, to be better, to do better, to be a tributary of good, a tributary of change. And I think through what I'm doing, through my platforms, understanding that I'm a celebrity and I have a voice, and it's important that I use it in the right way to create awareness for all the right things, I think Udada would have loved that very much. He did that himself, and I think as a South African, all you want to do is kind of embody that in any shape or form, in a little part of your life somewhere, every single day.
Yeah. Mm. And Udada also fought for our equality and
Absolutely.
Our freedom. And we are very grateful that we are free today, but then we can't really deny we're not really equal.
Absolutely.
What do you make of, from your point of view, South Africa today? And do you think that he'd be proud of South Africa today?
what do I think of South Africa today? South Africa is a young country. We're not even in our mid-20s, you know? So we are still finding our feet. We have a painful past. We, and through social media, you know, our wounds are exposed. Things that we cannot run away from anymore are happening, and we are forced to talk about them. South Africa is alive with possibilities. It is a country with kind people. It is a country with people who embody the spirit of Udada, I think, in making sure that you are humble and that, you know, you have humility. What would he be proud? I think he would feel we could be better and would do better, but I think he is happy with where we are and what is about to happen. You know, we have a new president. It came with a little bit of rejuvenation. South Africans, I think, walk with their heads, you know, held a little bit higher now, because I think we have a man who really represents us. Well, let's wait and see. But I think we have a fresh new start, and it feels like a fresh new canvas. And I think Udata would, you know, would be, we've done fine.
Yes.
Yeah, we passed with a B plus. It can be an A, but I think Tata is wherever are good, my kids.
You're getting there.
Yeah. Surely but surely.
A bit more work, but you'll be fine.
Yeah.